डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. आई डॉक्टर सुमन शर्मा टीचिंग यू सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर्स. स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड यूरिया फॉर्मेल्डिहाइड रेजिन्स. टुडे आई विल टीच यू द इपॉक्सी रेजिन्स. नाउ व्हाट आर इपॉक्सी रेजिन्स? इपॉक्सी रेजिन्स द रेजिन्स विच हैव at least two epoxy groups per molecule are known as epoxy resins. Okay, now epoxide. An epoxide is a cyclic ether with a three atom ring, right? Here is the structure of epoxy resin, and ether is R-O-R-dash. For example is ethyl ether, CH3CH2OCH2CH3, right? Come to the next slide. A polymer formed by reacting epoxide unit is called a polyepoxide or an epoxide, right? Epoxy is a copolymer, that is, it is formed from two different chemicals. These are referred to as the resin or compound and the hardener or activator, right? Epoxy, also known as polyepoxide, is a thermosetting polymer formed from reaction of an epoxide resin with polyamine hardener, right? So it's the general introduction of epoxy resin, okay? And it's a very important example of addition polymerization. Yogatmak bahulikaran ka ek, ye ek bahut hi important example hai, right? Then epoxides are polymerizable thermosetting resins containing one or more epoxide groups curable by reaction with amines, acids, amides, alcohols, phenols, acid anhydrides or mercaptans, right? The polymers are available in a variety of viscosities from liquid to solid, right? The common starting material is diglycerol ether of bisphenol A, DGEBA, which contain two epoxide groups, one at each end of the molecule. Okay, it's the common starting material for the preparation of epoxy resin, right? Now, most common epoxy resins are produced from a reaction between epichlorohydrin and bisphenol, right? The hardener consists of polyamine monomers, for example, triethylene tetraamine, TETA. Okay, when these compounds are mixed, the amine groups react with the epoxide groups to form a covalent bond. Okay, each NH group can react with an epoxide group from distinct prepolymer molecule, so that the resulting polymer is heavily cross-linked and is thus rigid and strong. Okay, now so these are the basic starting materials for the preparation of epoxy resins, right? Then come to the properties. What are the properties of epoxy resin? Properties of epoxy resins: make an excellent matrix material because of their versatility, right? Good handling characteristics, low shrinkages, excellent adhesive properties, flame resistant, good chemical resistance, good mechanical properties including toughness, okay, offer considerable variety for formulating prepreg resins, okay. Then hot moldings, cold moldings rarely, okay. ये तो rarely होता है, और जो है most जो abundant है that is hot molding, right. Then high smoke emission, okay. Curing temperature is 120 to 175 degree centigrade or 250 to 3500 Fahrenheit, and no byproducts formed during cure. It's the very important property of epoxy resin. कोई भी बाई प्रोडक्ट जो है वो क्योरिंग के टाइम जो है उसका फॉर्मेशन नहीं होता है. ओके, कम टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. देन कम्स टू द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ इपॉक्सी रेजिन. फर्स्ट इज डाइल्यूएंट्स, रिड्यूस द विस्कोसिटी. देन फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एजेंट्स मेक इपॉक्सी फ्लेक्सिबल. अदर एजेंट्स प्रोटेक्शन अगेंस्ट यूवी, राइट. क्यूरिंग एजेंट्स ऑर्गेनिक एमिनो कंपाउंड्स, एंड टू ऑब्टेन क्रॉस लिंकिंग बाय इंट्रोड्यूसिंग केमिकल्स दैट रिएक्ट विद द इपॉक्सी एंड द हाइड्रोक्साइल ग्रुप्स बिटवीन एडजेसेंट चेन्स. ओके, देन क्रॉस लिंकिंग, स्टिफनेस स्ट्रेंथ इंक्रीजेस बट टफनेस डिक्रीजेस. ओके, then B stage, an epoxy before it is fully cross linked is said to be in stage 2. Okay, in stage B epoxy has characteristic tackiness. Okay, the curing reaction can be lowered by lowering the reaction temperature. So these are the characteristic properties of B stage. Okay, then general method of preparation of epoxy resin, and it's the chemical reactions for the preparation of epoxy resin. Now first step is formation of low molecular weight prepolymer called dye epoxy. Okay, here is the bisphenol A, here is the epic halohydrene. Okay, reaction with NaOH and we get this product, right. Epoxy prepolymer formed from bisphenol A and epichlorohydrene by step growth polymerization, right. Here is the formation of prepolymer take place, and this is formed with these two reactants in presence of NaOH, right. Come to the next slide. The first thing that happens is that the NaOH does a little swap with the bisphenol A to give the bisphenol A sodium salt. Here is the formation of bisphenol A sodium salt. So it's the first step जहाँ पर कि bisphenol A sodium salt का formation होता है, right? Okay, this is the total mechanism for the preparation of bisphenol sodium salt A. Okay, then come to the step 2. Second is the curing the dye epoxy with a diamine, right. It's a diamine, it's a epoxide, reaction take place, we get this product, further its reaction with ether and we get this product. Okay, it's a diamine. Right, here is the mechanism of the reaction. The diamine's electrons attack the carbon atom next to the epoxide oxygen, giving us a negative charge. Okay, it's a negative charge on the oxygen and a positive charge on the nitrogen. Right, here is the diamine electrons attack the carbon next to the carbon of epoxide oxygen, giving us a negative charge on the oxygen and positive charge on the nitrogen. Right, this slide shows these characteristics. Okay, and here is the oxygen's extra pair of electrons sweeps a hydrogen from the ammonium nitrogen, making an alcohol group. Okay, and an amine group. Right, here is the alcohol group and here is the amine group. Okay, come to the next slide. And another epoxide end group adds to the same amine group. Right, it's add to the same amine group. Okay, and then two more epoxide groups add to the amine at the other end of the diamine, eventually tying all the diepoxy oligomers into one big molecular network. Right, here is the one big molecular network. Okay, now it's a very large jo hai epoxy resin, theek hai na, molecules. Then what are the disadvantages of epoxy resins? First is the brittleness and reduction in the properties in the presence of moisture. Okay, slower processing time than polyesters, more expensive than polyesters. So these are the disadvantages of epoxy resins. Right, then applications of epoxy resins. First is the used in aircraft construction. Okay, aircraft ki construction mein isko use mein liya jata hai. Second is cryogenic applications like epoxy nylon, epoxy amide have good retention of both tensile strength and elongation at cryogenic temperatures, and are usually the only materials that will work well at these temperatures. Right, and bridge structures, epoxy reinforced concrete, carbon reinforced epoxy structures and glass reinforced epoxy structures. Right, so these are the applications of epoxy resins. Okay, thank you, dear students.